Welcome to the Lego Loft, and today we're going to be building and reviewing the Lego Marvel Super Heroes The Hulkbuster Smash Set. So let's have a look at this box then. This is tied in with the Marvel Avengers Age of Ultron movie, which is coming out very shortly, and I can't wait for that movie. And there's some action scenes going on with the Lego there. The top of the box, the sides, and the bottom. Right, let's get that opened. We've got the tabs right here. Let's push them in. Got a little pamphlet there. Aha, there's a little comic book. The instructions. Got some stickers. Bag with a big fig in there. Bag number one, some mainly plates in there, I think, for all the bits. Bag number two, bag number three. So me and Piper are gonna build that up now. So that's everything built there, folks, and there's lots to talk about here. Firstly, we're going to talk about the Hulkbuster suit itself, the main focus of the set. I think it's pretty fantastic. It's very poseable. The arms have got two joints there, and we've got very nice fingers. I like the use of pieces, the way they've made these hands. It's fantastic. Of course, there's different detail on both the hands. That's plain. It looks good, but on this side, we've got the stud shooters. I'll come back to them in a minute. The legs are very poseable as well. Two joints on each. And inside there, he can stand up any way he likes. Look at that. Inside there we've got Iron Man, and we can easily get him out like that. And put him in like that. We'll leave him out for the minute. We'll need him for the next bit. So, let's have a go with those stud shooters. Normally you just shoot studs. But they've put cylinders on here for a bit of extra firepower. Shoot them in my hand. Bam. Bam. Of course, that's two of them fired off, which are there. But we got a couple of spare ones as well. So that's pretty cool. Oh, let's have a look at the next thing. So this is the side build we have. It's some sort of contraption to hold the Hulk in. I'll show you around it. That they've come down those flaps like that. That's sticker pieces on there, which they look really nice, but I never really like sticker pieces on my Lego. I like prints. They're easier to clean and, you know, but never mind. We've got that. I've never seen that before, but I know why it's there, and I'll go through that in a little while. Have a look at all the sides. Right, so basically the way this works, they come down the Hulk. I don't know how they get the Hulk in there in the first place. Hopefully the movie will shed light on that. I can't wait for that. It's coming out very soon. So he's in there trapped, but I think it's not just technology trapping him. I think it's a combo. I'm not sure. It's a combination of technology and maybe Scarlet Witch's magic, if indeed she does use magic in the movie. She needs to balance a little bit there. There she is. And the play feature, I think, here is we get a super jumper. And I've put these cylinder pieces in there already because it's a well-known fact now, but I'll tell you anyway. These things aren't very well manufactured and they can damage your minifigure's leg. So you can protect the legs by putting these on first. If you can stand them on there. And these work by, I'll show you first there, squeezing that down and pop, off he goes. So you've got a real flying Iron Man here. But let's see. The idea, I think, is to knock Scarlet Witch off there so she can't contain the Hulk anymore. Let's see if I can get it. Oh! One more try. I'll pick him up off the floor. Let's see. No! He's trapped in there now with him. But the way it's supposed to work is if you hit her, she would fall over because it's very finely balanced. And then you can pretend the Hulk comes out and rampages and smashes. Whatever he wants to do. Who's going to argue with the Hulk? So that's that little bit. So here's the minifigs included with the set. We've got three minifigs and one big fig. From left to right, we've got Iron Man. We've got Scarlet Witch. We've got Ultron, and we've got the Incredible Hulk. And here's a closer look at Iron Man. I'll pop his face up. So there's one face. And there's his alternate face. I'll take a look all around at the print we've got on here for him. So, I can't recall which Mark Iron Man suit this is. Frankly, I don't much care. Iron Man is Iron Man. It's an iconic suit. They can't stray too far from the design. I just love the basic elements of these, especially on minifig scale. As long as it's an iconic, eye-catching, recognizable figure, I'm a happy man. So there's a closer look at Scarlet Witch. And I'll bring her closer up to the camera. I think the print's very nice on the torso. I don't really know how movie accurate it is, but it's very nice nonetheless. And there's I think that's our main face, and we'll just pop her hair off for the alternate face. It's an angry face, fiery red eyes. So something's gone on there to make her mad. And we've got Ultron here, the bad guy of the movie. And he's some kind of a robot, I think, created by Tony Stark. I don't know if that's a spoiler. I think everybody knows that. And he's got printing on the back of the head. I don't think that's an alternate face. I think that's just a nice bit of detail there for his head. And there's printing on the back of the torso, the front and the legs. So that's quite a nice little minifigure for the bad guy. So here's a closer look at the Hulk big fig. And his arms move like that. Smash, 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 smash. And his fists move. And I think one of the features of the Hulk big figs, I think it's all of them. I think it might be all of the big figs, but I haven't really seen any others but the Hulks. You can carry the minifigs in there like that. That's pretty cool. Smash, smash. So that's pretty cool. And in this particular version of him, we've got the A for Avengers on his shorts. So you know whose team he's on, I think. So there it is, folks. That's everything from this set all together. And I think that's a very nice set indeed. What do you think? Comment below and let us know. I think it's mainly good for the Hulkbuster suit. But I love the figures, the side builds, it's got nice play features. It's a very nice set altogether. Thank you very much for watching. And if you've enjoyed this video, subscribe to the LEGO Loft, where we release new videos regularly. Marvel at the spare pieces. Spare.